Hi everyone, it's Kathy Zilski. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I've got a sweet card project that features some charming products from Pretty Pink Posh. This card features some very simple Copic coloring as well as some very simple stenciling. So let's jump in and take a look at the products. The stamps I'm using today are called Tropical Birds, and there are coordinating dies available. I'm also using a stencil, and this is the Tropical Background, and I'm going to do some ink blending over the stencil. I've got just two colors of Gina K ink and some Memento ink for stamping, and I will be using my life-changing brushes to apply color. I've got some Citrus Mix Jewels, a few Copic markers here, and of course everything will be listed below. And I'm going to be using Pixie Spray today. This stuff is fantastic for holding your stencils onto your projects without adding any adhesive residue to your projects. I'll just be using some Nina Solar White Classic Crest cardstock for my project today and a few other things as I go. First things first, I'm going to stamp my images to color. Now this is new for me. Normally I pull out my Misti, but I am trying to get a little better with just, well, I like to call it free range stamping, where I just put something on a block. It's old school. Many of you who've been stamping for years are thinking, yeah, Kath, we've been doing this since the dawn of time. Me, not so much, but you know what? Those look pretty good. Clean it off with my tidy towel, and I've got three flamingos to color. Now, RV10, see that little? That's the actual pink, not RV21. Have you ever put your caps on your pens incorrectly and then you grab the... That's exactly what I did. I'm not a master. I'm not a master with Copics. And that leads me to my point here. Copic coloring intimidates me. I wanted a pink flamingo and I knew, just keep it simple, Kath. Just keep it simple. It doesn't have to have the masterful shading of, well, the masters. Just color it in, do your best, and make your flamingo pink. I decided to go in on the beak, add a little color. I actually went outside the beak, and that is why for a newbie or a novice like me, you can push that color right back in. It works like an eraser. Now, I thought that looked pretty good, so I didn't need to color the other two. I always stamp backups, because usually I make mistakes. I thought that looked great. And I just want to show you, I really do stamp and practice, and then I have no idea what I'm doing, and I try to get fancy. That's when I just keep it simple. So, now I do know a little bit about Pixie Spray, though. I really like this stuff. It is a low-tack adhesive, and you can spray it on the back of your stencil, and with a heavily detailed stencil like this, it's very helpful. Very helpful to keep all of those little tiny things in place. So all I am doing here is starting in the center. This is Jelly Bean Green ink from Gina K Designs. I just want to come out very lightly and create that soft blend from the center. These life-changing brushes have helped me with ink blending a great deal. Yes, they are. Well, they're not cheap, but I think they're a really good investment because I am getting better at blending all the time. And I taped my stencil down just to make sure if I had to lay it back over, but it looked good, so I'll just wash that off and set it aside. Now I'm framing out the panel that I want to cut. And the flamingo looks good. I'm going to add a little bit of text in here. And so I'm placing it into my Misti. This is where I will not free range it. I'm going to even bring in one of my creative corners to really help keep that aloha perfectly straight. And I'll make sure that panel is positioned again. And just ink it up with some Memento Tuxedo Black and just give it a light pressure. I like to just run a little cloth over it because my fingers tend to stick. Not that I have sticky, well, maybe sometimes I do. Repeating the process for the sub-sentiment, and there we have Aloha, Wish You Were Here. Now I'm going to create another panel. And this is really an optional step, but I thought I wanted my card to have a little bit more color. And so I'm just adding a little bit of the dusty rose color to the outer edges, again, using the same stencil and another life-changing brush. I thought this would just create a little more interest, and I lifted it up and I thought, yeah, it looked pretty good. But after I let it sit and it dried back, I realized, eh, it's a little light. So I did a second panel. The second panel was darker, and I thought that is going to give me more of a pop because it's already a soft color. So now onto building the cart. I'm going to score this at 5.5 so that it will be a top folding cart. It will be 5.5 tall by 4.25 wide. That is the US A2 measurement. And I always like to tape my cards closed because that cardstock tends to pop up. And I'm going to use some dot adhesive here. This is just my Gina K dot runner to add that panel to the back. So you can see how it has a little bit of framing margin space there. It lets a little of that white come through. And now I've added foam tape to the back of both my blended panel and my flamingo. And I will pop that up in the center. And then I'll go ahead and add my flamingo, just like that. It's pretty simple, but I liked having that little bit of pink pop out. Now, I'm using this little glue holder. I get asked about this sometimes, and I'll link it below. It's from a cute little Etsy shop, and they have all different colors and styles, but it's great for holding your glue while you're working. And I've started experimenting with the pick-me-up stick, right, this little sticky tool, and my craft pick as a way to add jewels. I'm not great adding jewels. I swear if I've used a jewel picker and I have not managed to succeed, but using those tools together, it works just fine. Thanks so much for watching today. I would love to have you become a subscriber to my channel, and I will see you back here with another card project soon.